All right, friends, man, I hope everybody is ready for this word. There's a lot of times that I go to prayer and I get a good word from the Lord. I really feel encouraged or excited or equipped in the place of prayer. There's so many times I go to prayer and I get a word and I'm stirred up, I'm excited about it, and I kind of just spend extra time with the Lord on it. Well, this word was given to me a few days ago in prayer, and when I got this word, I became extremely excited about this word from the Lord, but I knew it was one of those words that you just don't jump on social media and you go sharing. I knew that it was a word that the Lord wanted me to spend a few days on and really get into to prayer on and really bathe it in prayer and meditate on this word. And so I did, and then even this morning when I woke up, the Lord started just downloading very, very powerful deposits on this prophetic word. And then the Lord really spoke to me strong that this is the start of the rest of this year, that this word is going to propel people further into what that He's called them to do. And so this word that I'm going to release is a word I feel that is for July, but also this powerful prophetic word of the Lord is going to be a stabilizing and a foundational word that you can actually stand on throughout the rest of the year. Now, before I get into this word, I want you to understand the Lord spoke to me in the middle of May that the month of June was a month that people need to solidify their foundation, spend extra time in fasting, spend extra time in prayer. Throughout that time, God gave me some very, very powerful prophetic words. Now, you can go to our YouTube channel and you can hear some of these words. One, what was like blueprints. Listen, you cannot follow a blueprint of somebody else in this season. You got to have a life led by the Holy Spirit. The Lord gave me another powerful word about critical release. God gave me another powerful word about your coming out of this season, going into your next season. Then I heard a word, one of my favorite words is everything is falling into place. Another word, everything's about to make sense. All these prophetic words actually started coming to me probably in about the last 10 to 12 days. And they were just every day, I was telling my wife, every day the Lord gives me a new word that actually builds on the word that I got the day before. And you know, it's one of those things, I don't seek the Lord for prophetic words. I just seek the Lord for Him because I love Him so much. But He's given me these words. So all of these words have been building up. And another one was the Lord spoke to me and said, doors are about to open for many people. Be ready. And so those were just some of the last few words that God really spoke to me about. So hope you're excited about all of those. And please go back and watch those. There was another one called Infamous to Entrusted. Infamous is when somebody is known for a bad deed or quality. And the Lord says, I want to trust people, but I can't trust them with stuff that will make them infamous. Okay? Those were words I've got over the last 10 or 12 days. Please go back on our YouTube, watch those. So let's get into this word. A few days ago in prayer, our corporate prayer meeting, I was seeking the Lord, and the Lord just spoke this word to me so strong. And He said, rehearsal to release. And I said, okay, that's a good word, rehearsal to release. All right, God, I wrote it down, rehearsal to release. And I sat on it. And the next day I was praying. I said, God, do you have anything else on that word? And He started revealing the next day, then the next day, then this morning I woke up and the Lord spoke a powerful word about that word. And the cool thing was the meaning was deeper than I even thought it was. Rehearsal to release. Now, let's get into the word rehearsal. The word rehearsal actually means a practice or trial performance before a later or bigger performance. Okay, then the Lord was speaking to me. The process leads to the real reason why you're going to do something. Now, the word release is so good. And I didn't even fully know this, what the word release meant. The word release means escape from confinement, allow to move, act, or flow freely. And then this is what the Lord gave me this morning for me to release this word to you. Rehearsal to release. The Lord started speaking to me. Rehearsal will lead them to the release. And the Lord was reminding me of all the prophetic words I mentioned a while ago. And they all come together to lead up to this right here. This is your prophetic word for July that you can run with. Okay, friends? See, you know, Matthew 6 and 6 says, "But you go into your room, shut your door, pray to your Father who sees in the secret place, and your Father who sees in the secret place will reward you openly." Okay, openly. The Lord showed me that. I said, "God, I've been preaching that scripture for years." The Lord said, "What is the last part?" He will reward you openly. Why did God say rehearsal? I started thinking about my daughter's been in dress rehearsals. They've been in some one-act plays. And the person who went through the practices, who trained the best, got the starting row and was actually rewarded openly. The Lord told me about 6 years ago, I was praying, and the Lord said, "I want to release John the Baptist upon America." The Lord said, "I'm calling hundreds of them, but only a few will get to the place to fully be released openly to America. They will be known, their voice will be known, because they've actually hid themselves in the place of prayer." But over those years, it was almost like it was a rehearsal that led to the release of these voices. And I know that I'm one of them. What the Lord was showing me is every trial that you went through, every test that you went through, every criticism that you made it through, every single thing that you made it through, that you went through, you may have been crawling, but you went through it. All of it was a rehearsal to lead you to your release. My wife and I were talking last night. Everybody prays for the breakthrough, the miracle moment. What if your breakthrough is actually you having the ability to stand through a process and make it through a process so you can grow through the process, not go through the process? See, everybody wants the next big door. They want the favor of God. They want the blessing of God. But if you actually got what the Lord has put in your heart and you've been praying for, if you actually received the full manifestation, it would kill some of you right now. It would actually destroy you because you couldn't handle in the natural what he wanted to pour out in the spiritual. And I hope you're hearing this. Everything you go through, every time I go through a hardship, I tell my wife, I'm kind of excited about this hardship because I understand what is on the other side. Therefore, when people, you know, come against me, try to come against me with word curses or verbal abuse or speak against what we're doing, I don't get mad anymore. I don't get on social media and say, "Oh, the warfare is unbearable." No. I'm gonna break through this. I'm gonna go through this in Jesus' name. I'm gonna flow with the Holy Spirit. I'm going to get through this rehearsal because I'm about to be released into the greater. Now, man, let me just go and tell you, over the last 7 or 8 days, my wife and I have had doors of opportunity just open up for us. We've had new streams of income. I just started a new business this week. I am going to be a health coach. Man, if you want some information on that, message me privately. I got on a program to lose some weight because of a past surgery I had. And in 3 days, I was blown away with how I felt the results. So I called and I said, "I want to be a coach in this organization." New doors are opening up. Recently, I started doing something through social media. My goodness, opened up doors of ministry, opened up doors of financing. Everything I did in the past was just a rehearsal to lead me through this. I remember when my little girls were in dance. They were like, "Dad, we got so many rehearsals." They were in the Nutcracker Ballet. "Dad, we got so many practices. We got so many rehearsals. We're doing all of this all the time." But on the final night, when the spotlight was on and all the people were there, it was worth it. I'm going to tell you right now, everything you've been through, every rehearsal, every situation, it's going to be worth it. I remember my girls were in one act play, and they were like, we would be in a rehearsal, and they would say, stop, you need to do this, this, and this. They would start acting again, stop, you need to do this, this, and this. Stop, you need to do this, this, and this. And they're like, why are we always stopping? Dress rehearsal for the ballets they were in, dress rehearsals, they would stop. When the curtain comes up and the lights come on, there ain't no stopping. My friends, I'm going to tell you something. Listen to me. Whatever social media form you're watching this on, Facebook, YouTube, you got to share this. And here is why. Because there comes a place in your ministry, there comes a place in your business, there comes a place where nothing can stop you. The release happens. Why did I say release was? Release is the escape from confinement. Listen, friends, this is from the Lord. Some of you feel like you've been in a rehearsal for years. You start, someone says stop. You start, someone says stop. You start, someone says stop. No, you need to go in this position. You don't fit here in this part of the play. No, we're going to change your role. We're going to move you over here in the ballet. We're going to move you here. We're going to shift you here. Stop. We're going to redo this. We're going to rewrite this. We're going to redo this. We're going to recast it. We're going to re. No. When the release happens, you escape from confinement. Escape from confinement. Then you actually start to move, act, and flow freely. You flow freely. My wife and I just entered a place in our life. Actually, yesterday morning, my wife and kids were laughing at me, and they were like, Dad, you are so excited. I've never seen you more energetic. I've never seen you more excited. I've never seen you like this. And I tell them, I said, I don't know fully what has happened. But when I started this health program, when I got off of another fast, when I dove into the Word of God more, and years and years and years, did I say years? Years of being in a rehearsal, I feel like my first 24 years of ministry have been a rehearsal. But my God, I'm telling you today, the doors have swung wide open, and there has been a release in our church, in our apostolic network, book writing. Man, my wife and I both released a book last Friday, and I'm going to release another one here in about 8 more weeks. There is a free flow. I am released. No more confinement. My health, I feel so alive inside. No more confinement. I mean, this is it. My wife and I have been talking about our marriage. Our marriage is in the best place it has ever been. 19 and a half years of almost like a rehearsal in marriage, our marriage is the best it's ever been. Our relationship with our kids are the best it's ever been. I'm telling you, my friends, this is a word of the Lord for you. You gotta grab a hold. This word is the July word from the Lord that I'm releasing, but I'm telling you, it is a word to push you through the rest of the year. And I even think this word is going to carry over into your 2020. I've been saying that all year, that this year is just going to roll right into 2020. And that's the word. The process that you've been through, is leading you into your real moment. My wife and I, we... just even a few years ago, we said, we're going to minister to people, spirit, soul, and body. So we started a website and a YouTube channel called Living Our Best Life. But we didn't have all the answers. We were so obedient and started. Yesterday on our coffee date, we said, now we have our answers. We minister to people in the spirit. Roar Church, Texarkana, Roar Apostolic Network, which creates Roar Apostolic Family. a lot of the soul we minister to people on YouTube. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's going great. My Facebook Lives, I'm there to minister to people. Now the body, now we're becoming health coaches because I joined a program. It changed my life, and now I want to help other people change their physical life. You got to understand, I'm 44 years young. Y'all thought I was 30, but I'm 44. My whole first 44 years has been a rehearsal. I am happier. I am happier. Listen to me. I am happier than I've ever been in my life. My relationship with God is better than it's ever been before. I feel like my first 44 years have been a rehearsal for now. I know exactly what I'm doing with my life. I know exactly what I've been called to do, and I am going to do it. This word is a word for me as well. Rehearsal to release. Rehearsal leads to release. I hope this prophetic word of the month for July helps you, encourages you, and strengthens you. Now go out there and live the life that God has called you to live.